Hey, TCS TV viewers, it's Dave and Evelyn from the Camera Store. Today we're very excited. We're coming to you from the Red Bull Arena in New Jersey.
And that's because Sony flew us out here to check out two new products, including
600 f4,
as well as a 200 to 600 millimeter lens.
Let's go shoot some soccer. Talk about the latest super telephoto from Sony, the 600 f4 G Master lens with optical stabilization. Now, we had a chance last night to shoot the Red Bull soccer game, and it was a pleasure to use.
Yeah, Dave had a little bit of a hard time giving it up so we could share it, but we both had the opportunity to shoot with this lens, and it has an XD linear focus motor with high thrust actuators. And the reason why that's so important is because it's able to keep up with the Sony A9's focusing speed, so it can shoot 20 frames per second, but it's also able to keep up with all those little focusing calculations, so it can do the real-time tracking autofocus. And of course, shooting any kind of sports with real-time tracking autofocus is impressive. I mean, you're able to focus on your composition, you're able to get the action that you want, and you're able to make sure that you really nail that focus when you're in the moment.
Yeah, now this combination of A9 plus the 600 f4 allowed me to acquire focus extremely quick and follow and track action like I've never done before. I really liked it. Now, the other thing I loved about this lens was the weight. The 600 f4 is a big lens physically, but this weighs 3,040 grams.
Yes, to give you a little bit of perspective, it's actually 3.3 pounds lighter than the combination of a Nikkor 600 millimeter lens with a D5. So for pro photographers, this could be a big deal in order for them to save a little bit of weight and protect their backs.
Let's talk about the design of this lens a little bit. Now, if it looks a lot like the 400 2.8 G Master, you are absolutely correct. In fact, the dimensions of the focusing ring and the custom controls are identical to the 400 G Master. We do have four custom buttons here, and by default, they are set for focus lock, but you can customize what you want. The ring beside here is also customizable as well, with a few less options. The back end of the lens here, we have the kind of controls we'd expect on a lens of this caliber, and of course, we have a drop-in ND filter or a circular polarizer.
So just like the 400 millimeter lens, this is really well balanced. It has 18 groups with 24 elements, and that's with ED glass, and so that helps prevent chromatic aberration. It also has an extreme spherical lens, which helps prevent spherical aberration. And so it's giving you really nice sharpness, resolution, and prevents a lot of issues that you could normally have with these super telephoto lenses. It's also extremely well balanced with a lot of weight in the center, and that helps with these lightweight Sony bodies.
So this lens is very well built, from a great hood to a nice little touches like this padded grip here. This lens is what you'd expect as far as build quality goes, but none of it matters unless it performs optimally.
It has great edge-to-edge sharpness, beautiful bokeh, great color rendition. Now, of course, that 600 millimeter range does seem really tight for a lot of indoor stadiums. However, a lot of pros will tell you that now they're required to have longer lenses because they're being pushed further and further away from the athletes.
As professional sports photographers, we're getting moved further and further back for all sorts of different reasons, whether it's for safety, for legal reasons, and other places. And so with this new 600, we have that reach now in the Sony lineup that the others have had for a little while. So it's pretty exciting. Coming up covering swimming in Korea, it's a bread and butter for swimming because we're usually up in the stands. Alpine skiing, it's always 600 or 800, it's never 400. So it's really important. And the amazing thing is how light it is.
So if 600 millimeters is not enough range for you, and I'm talking to you birders, it is fully compatible with the 1.4 and 2x teleconverters, and because we're starting with such wicked optics, we don't really pay a penalty for using them.
Now, I know the 600 millimeter lens is really fun to talk about. It's a pretty amazing lens, but I think we should start talking to you about the real star of the show. And that's this 200 to 600 at 5.6 to 6.3 optical image stabilized lens. First of all, this focal range is really great. It's excellent for wildlife photography, sport photography, and a lot of other applications. And this is actually the first native full frame mirrorless super telephoto zoom lens on the market. And Sony's done some really great things with it. I really like that they have the full internal zoom, and the throw on this is extremely quick. So when you're moving from 200 to 600 millimeters, you can do that really quickly and keep up with the action. So yesterday when we were shooting soccer, I had a lot more fun with this lens compared to the 600 millimeters because I was able to quickly get focus and actually get what I wanted in the shot. So when the ball and the action was coming closer to me, I could quickly move to 200. And then when it was going further away, I still had that reach to get to the 600 millimeter mark. When it comes to image quality, the 200 to 600 millimeter lens is looking really sharp for this focal range. And it's not gonna blow you away as much as the 600 millimeter f4 lens, but that's primarily because you're not able to throw the background out as much for sports photography. The maximum aperture is f6.3 at the long end, and so you're not able to get that nice subject separation like you would in the Pro G Master lens. Now this lens is optically stabilized, and you have three different optical stabilization modes that you can choose from and adjust on this panel. You also have three by default focus hold buttons that you can customize to another control if you like. And although this is not a G Master lens, it does have a really nice professional feel to it, and it's also weather sealed.
So last night at the Red Bulls Arena, we were able to shoot soccer with this lens. The 2 to 600 is not a G Master lens, but it's a G Series lens, and I was very impressed with the sharpness this lens is capable of delivering. Now you can throw on a 1.4 or a 2x converter.
One thing we can both agree on is these lenses were really fun to shoot with, and it's amazing how well they're able to keep up with Sony's technology, especially that real-time tracking autofocus. It's crazy how fast it is.
Yeah, being able to play with the premium quality 600 f4 or the 2 to 600 5.6 to 6.3 lens, both have been a pleasure to use.
Let us know which lens you're more excited about. Is it the 600 millimeter G Master f4 lens?
Or the 2 to 600 5.6 to 6.3 lens?
Please leave your comments below, and if you're new to the channel, please subscribe.
And make sure you follow us on Instagram.
And hit that notification bell so we can catch you again really soon.